All right, here we are, Ralph Hardiman in the Memphis Drum Shop, and this has got to be the baddest drum shop I've ever seen, the facilities here. So, if you ever get a chance, stop on by, because it's the spot, you know, and it's a little bit more in the shop. It's like a whole block long, and it's got, I'm not going to tell you what's in here, but I did want to introduce I got a couple of new sticks out from Vic Firth. They're made out of this Stay-Pak wood. It's heavy. It's crazy. And it's great for, it's a chop builders. This particular one right here, it's called a hammer, and rightfully so. Don't hit anybody with it. You'll be in trouble. But it's basically, you know, for just warming the chops up, you know, and you'll find you play with these for a while. You got to be careful with blisters and such, but you play with these for a while, and you go back to your regular sticks, and you're hauling pretty good. It's not an overnight thing, so don't think that just because you're going to pick up some of these and then, like, the next day you're going to be king drummer of the universe, because it doesn't work that way, and you know. But it is. It does work the chops, and they're heavy. So here's a little bit of sound from it if you want to check it out. Okay. Down. Anyways, check it out. These are the hammers. Here's a couple more. The chop outs. Same wood, everything, except for it's got a nice rubber tip. So you know how you crazy drummers are. You like to pound on everything, including mom's table. And you might be able to get away with using these on mom's table for a second, but I wouldn't recommend it. But it's got a nice hard rubber bead on it, and check it out. Listen. Fun to play with. So it's great on pads, as you guys can see. The sound is nice and light. It's not offensive. And you know how we can be sometimes, us drummers. We can get on people's nerves if we're not really making music. Something to think about. Anyway, so yeah. We got the hammers here, and they're both made out of Stay-Pak wood. These are the chop-outs, just the names, and they have the rubber beads on it. It's great for different effects, especially in the marching world, because we're pretty loud. But, you know, we like to play soft, too, and this creates a whole different timbre and just another sound that you can use on the drum. So there's lots of things you can do with it, for sure. For me, basically, it's just working the chops, and us drum corps guys really love chops, especially the young players. I'm about worn out these days, but I can still teach a mean you-know-what. Playing, that's another thing. The youngsters are so hot at that, at this stuff, it's ridiculous. Anyways, getting back to these sticks, I'd recommend check them out, see if it's your cup of tea. But basically, it's for working on the chops. I wouldn't recommend on playing on the drums too long with the hammers, just because this stuff is really, really heavy, and you know, you might do some damage. Something to think about. All right, later. Ha ha ha.